Hello everyone, how are you all? Welcome to IT class. This is your IT teacher Sumit Sadana. We have already covered our four units, that is unit 1, 2, 3 and 4. Last we have covered our electronic spreadsheet. So now moving on to our next unit, that is unit 5, that is digital presentations. As you can already see on your screen, it's already viewed over there. So some introduction has been given to us, so we'll be covering everything in presentation, how to create a presentation, what is basically a presentation. So presentation is basically a sort of the idea of representing your views, your thoughts, your ideas, your knowledge in the form of text based regular text, in the form of list items, in the form of table, in the form of graphical elements. Graphical elements may include your photos, your GIF files, your moving images, right, your video, small clips, whatever you have created for the audience and all, so that your ideas or your thoughts could move on from you to the audience, right, from the presenter to the audience, those who are listening. And the presentation must be that efficient and effective one, so that it could create attraction, it could let the audience understand what you basically want to explain to them. That is known as presentation, right? So presentation skills include content as well as flow of presentation. So a speaker must have the appropriate and solid content to display, and side by side the flow of presentation should be there. There should not be any lag in between or any pause, or like pause, I'm not saying that you are speaking and you're not taking pause. Pause means like there should not be any kind of disturbance in the flow of your presentation. Okay, so there are number of advantages of using the presentation, right, which used to be prepared with the help of computers and all, right? A presentation must include some things that are displayed and listed here, that is regular text, whatever text you want to write, list items, you want to create a numbering, right, create a table also, add graphical elements like sound, video and animations. Animations are transitions, animations, basically the presentation of your content, how the one slide is coming, how after switching from one to another, what transition or animation you have used so that you could create attraction, so that you could engage all the audience whosoever is sitting in front of you and your presentation. So presentation is used to present the project proposal in business organization. This is one of the example, basically not only for project proposal, it is being used by the students also, right, to share or present their views regarding any of the topic given by the school or the subject teacher. So presentation is highly used in teaching and training. The concepts that are difficult to explain can be easily presented to the audience in simple way using any presentation software, and those presentation software can be Microsoft. You can see I am just showing you Microsoft PowerPoint, right, OpenOffice Impress and LibreOffice Impress. So in this unit we'll be covering with the help of LibreOffice Impress. I know you have not used it, so just listen it very carefully. So Impress is one of the important component of a LibreOffice suite from the document foundation and all, right? And this is basically an open source free software which you can download and all, I told you, right? So using Impress we can read MS PowerPoint presentations also and its templates. That means using Impress means whatever presentation we have created in PowerPoint, MS PowerPoint presentation and its templates can be imported in LibreOffice also, right? And LibreOffice is not a platform independent, it's a reliable software. It can work on Windows, Linux and Mac too, and every operating system, right? So it may look slightly different on different operating systems, So their characteristics of a good quality presentation must be number of lines. So a page or a slide must include 5 to 8 lines so that whatever topic you are just showing or explaining must be covered, right? Next is font size. The font size should be at that size so that it could be readable by each and every person who is acting as an audience, and those who are sitting at the back must be readable. Okay, so you should see about the font size, font style also, font face, and the color scheme too. Whatever is using, what color you are using at the background, and the bright color must be used in front of the text, in front of the back, on the background, right? If you are using black background, you must use white text color, or if you are using white background, you must use black or blue dark colors, right? So that it could easily be read by the audience. Correct use of grammar and language. You must be sound enough to write the sentences, or you must be proficient enough to create your own sentences or phrases, okay, so that no mistake should come at the presentation day. And if you make a mistake, then replicate to the number of persons in the audience. Replicate to the number of persons in the audience. If the mistake has come, mistake that will replicate to the number of persons in the audience, that means each and every person will see the problem, your mistake, and can be a problem, right? Cannot be a good impression from your side. You can insert the images also for better understanding. You can draw tables or graphs. If you are a business person, you can show your working, timings or the product promotion with the help of tables, some images, some graphs, so that you could show them that we are improving, or if you are not improving, recession, right, or the peak time is there. So you must take care of these things. Use of colors. Always use fair or silent background colors, or the dark colors for the fonts, right? So this has been given to us. Use fair or silent background colors and dark color for the font so that it could easily be read by the audience. Animation and videos. Do not include more than one animation or video in one slide. Basically, if you have used a transition, that is okay. But if you have used transition in one slide and at the same slide you are putting three paragraphs, and all those three paragraphs are having their own animation, that means one transition will be there, and after that one paragraph will come, then second paragraph, then third paragraph, means a total of four animations or effects you have implemented, and this can take a lot of time and can create a diversion between the audience. Means they won't be able to engage themselves, they'll get bored. Pay attention to target group. You have to create a presentation in that form where you have to see this thing, that what is my focus. Your focus must not be outdated. If you have used, or what kind of audience you want to be get targeted, right? So you must take care of these things, that my target is this. If I'll be explaining presentation, I must get this much feedback from the audience. I must need this, right? So this is the kind of some advantages or the thinking level which a presenter must see before creating a presentation. So now getting started actually with the LibreOffice Impress. So let me open. So the steps you can see, I'm clicking start, all programs, LibreOffice, then LibreOffice Impress. So I have just clicked, it has opened now, and by default at the welcome screen of this LibreOffice Impress, I got some opportunity that to select a template. Template is basically the full layout of a presentation. You want alizarin, beehive, blue curve. These are the built-in templates, right? According to your presentation, if your presentation is a kind of, you will be giving the presentation at the time of evening, so you can use the sunset, right? These are basically the combination of colors templates are all, right? Bright blue or classy red, DNA focus. These are just the names. You have to see the design only, that what kind of design they'll be covering. Beehive like this. So I'll be using this open. So and open. So this is created and the template is implemented successfully on our first ever presentation. So let me make you familiarize with all the things. This is basically the ribbon where you have a number of bars. First one is the menu bar, second one is the here. I told you in the digital documentation also, standard toolbar. Third one is here. This one is basically what? You have a number of drawing tools here, right? So this is the main layout, right? You can already see. So the parts of Impress has been given to us. File, edit, view, insert, format. This has been file, edit, view, insert, format, slideshow, tools, windows. So in files you have many options like saving, exporting, take the printout, exit, or set the templates. Edit, you can cut, copy, paste it, paste special, select all, find and replace, points, glue points. View, you can have a view of these like normal outline. I'm pressing the outline view. This is a kind of outline view. Normal view will give you the thumbnailed view, right? Next is or views of the slide sorter view, master slide view, right? Or master notes or master handouts. These are being used to give the printouts to different students, right? Normal. So standard toolbar, slide pane is there. This is a slide pane where you have first one is the property of a slide. Next is your slide transitions. You want to set the transition like after first, you will get the second slide in the form of this transition or vanishing or comb. Very good. Effects or transitions have been given to us like draw shade, 3D vanishing, and or vortex ripple is also a good one, right? So many good options have been or transitions have been provided to us, so we can customize according to our requirement. Table designs, custom animations, you can set slide transition. I just showed you drawing toolbar. This is basically the drawing toolbar, right? Insertion point, I is basically the insertion point, this I, right? Zoom control, you can zoom in, zoom out here, right? So next is closing the LibreOffice. You can just click exit. It will ask to save it. If you want to save, you can click on save. It will ask for a location where you want to save. Simply give the file name and that's it. It is done. So now some shortcut keys have been given to you. I just told you that all the shortcuts remain same. If I'll be pressing Alt F4, it will again ask for save because I am closing this application, or I'll click Control W then also, or I'll press Control Q then also, it will ask for closing it and saving it. Now creating a presentation using template. I shown you that using a template, I have just selected one of the good template from the template window, and once it is selected, right, so you have the layouts like whatever you want to write. When you click here on the properties, right, I'm writing here something. Clear? So this is basically the title. I'll be making it a little up, moving a little up so that next is your points, whatever points you want to write, right, or explanation or paragraph, you can easily write down. If you want to take the, you know, bullets and all, you can take the bullets, more bullets. I just show you what kind of bullets you want. Either you want these Roman numerals, right, or any color you want to give to them, or start from 1 or 2. You can see the preview here. Okay, so these are sizes. So if you want to increase the size, decrease the size, and the separator, whatever separator you want to use between. If you want space, so leave it black. If you want to give something, a dot or whatever, you can give. Okay, so indent is basically the spacing from beginning, and this is the width. Okay, relative, central line, left line, you want to make it relative, means all the things will be same. So apply to master or to the selection, like you want to apply these to selection or to the all the cells, but to the selection only. Okay, so I'll be writing not selected one. Suppose I am selecting this, so the point has come, right? So while pressing enter, you can have a new bullet, right? So these three points have come. So you want to make enlarge it, you can enlarge it, or that's it. They are already in the, you know, center position. Okay, and the shortcut to run a slideshow, you already know, that is F5. If I'm pressing F5 from the very starting of the slide, I'll get my presentation started, and no effect has been implemented here. So I'll try to implement, but stick to our topics. So whatever topic they given to us, side by side we'll be covering. Now is selecting slide layout. Slide layout can be selected from layouts, right, from a slide basically. So from slide you can have a layout. Different kind of layouts are there. First I have already used, I'll go to second, and here I will select the layout. This basically is the second slide where I have by default the title and add to text. So this is the text box where I can insert either the table or any graph or chart, any image or any video clip. Okay, so these all four are the links. So wherever I'll click, they will help me in inserting the respective operation. If I'll click the table, so I want five columns, two rows. So I'll click it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 row, 5 columns and 2 rows. Okay, so I'll be writing serial number, date, then particulars, sorry, then the selling price, or cost price, okay, or selling price or the profit. And press tab 1 and then second, date, today is 18, particulars, that is automatic shrink machine. Okay, so this is not coming inside, so I'll be enlarging it. Selling price, profit, what profit I have got, I got 1200. Okay, so like this you can insert it, insert, or if you want to insert the row here, so what you will do, you click here on the first, and now here I got some virtual bar where I can add or delete the rows and columns. So column is basically the vertical direction, rows are horizontal direction. You can see here, this is insertion, if I'll click this, so it will insert at the above or the above the row. If I'll click this, you can see the arrow, right, down, select, so another row has been inserted. If you want to insert the column before, so I'll click here, if you want to write, so at the right side I got the arrow. If you want to delete it, you can delete the row and column. This is selected, so I'm pressing just I'll click here, so I'll press the delete button, so column is deleted. So I'll click here, I want to delete this, so the column is deleted. Simple. So slide layout, so now I just want to apply slide layout to different slides. So how to insert a new slide, you usually double click it, okay, new slide used to come, or if you press Control M for mango, then also a slide will come or be inserted. Or if you want to right click and a new slide, here also shortcut is written, so you can then also insert a slide. Now changing our slide layout, I will go to slide layout. So these are basically some slide layouts built in which have been given to us. Title and content, a title and content will be there. Slide layout, only title is there, no content box is here now. So I'll be changing center text, so one text box is given with the center text alignment. Title and two content, so title and two content, can you see? It is very easy. You can go here also, you can even go at the layouts option here, so you can select whatever you want to select. It will give you a live preview. See, four contents, four images you want to, six images you want to insert, or four tables you want to show here differently for a comparison. You can give easily, right? Clear. Next is coming up with your adding text, saving a presentation. So this we have already given. So I'll press Ctrl S. It will ask for saving a presentation. I'll click on D. D drive will save it. Like this. 9th. Okay. So here are some options. See, if you want, your presentation should run in LibreOffice or OpenOffice presentation software only, then you will select ODF presentation, which is the first one. And if you want your presentation should be, you know, run on, or should be running on your this LibreOffice or OpenOffice presentation also, but beside these softwares, you want this my presentation to be, you know, started on that Microsoft PowerPoint also, then you can select these 2007 to 365 or PowerPoint 97 to 2003. Okay, these two options are there. 365 basically is the Office 2016 and 13, which is coming online also and offline now. Previously it was only online 2013, so that is Microsoft PowerPoint 2007 to 365 is an online software, a Microsoft Office software. So if I'll be clicking here, it will run before 2007 version. If I'll be clicking here, it will be PowerPoint 2007 onwards. Okay, so I'll click here. I'll show you both the case, in both the cases, to save ODF, then save. Okay, it is saved now. So I'll again save as to this one, save. Okay, keep use PowerPoint as a format. Okay, now I'll go to computer, D drive, and here I have saved two files. So I'll show you the type. This is for ODF open document presentation, this is for PowerPoint presentation. I right click, open with PowerPoint, so it will work here. Okay, see this, can you see? Yeah, same. Or if I'll be double clicking, or I'll be opening this in PowerPoint, this won't work because it asks for to repair, so repair won't be there and error will definitely be there. So saved just now. Your next is रनिंग अ स्लाइड शो और सेविंग अ प्रेजेंटेशन एज HTML, राइट, सो सेविंग एज अ PDF ऑल्सो, आई विल शो यू, दिस इज अवर प्रेजेंटेशन, रनिंग F5, प्रेसिंग F5, सो इट हैज जस्ट रन, यू हैव स्टार्टेड द स्लाइड शो एंड इफ आई विल बी प्रेसिंग एनी ऑफ द की, इट विल स्विच टू द सेकेंड प्रेजेंटेशन स्लाइड, इफ आई विल pressing click also, then also it will come to the next slide. If I'll click again, now it will be the end of the slideshow. Okay, so I just want my presentation should have one transition, right? So I'll go here, tiles, simply click on any of the transition. Now it is implemented. You can see a small star is here. Now applying transition on second circles, okay, now on third applying this iris, so three transitions have been applied here on my three slides. So now I'll be running this presentation by pressing F5. So now I got, and the next is click, so this is another transition, third one is the iris closer. Okay, so on third we won't have anything, so clear. So now saving a presentation as HTML, so save a presentation, save as, okay, so so here I will try to find option as, you know, or HTML. So I don't think there is any HTML. But yes, it's not in save, it's in export. Click on file or export. Click on export. So it will ask for whether you want to export as a PDF file, as HTML. If I'll be saving as HTML, save. Okay, this is a new design. Standard HTML will be there, not webcast and all. It will be a standard HTML, right? Because in a webcast we have to give the URLs and all. Only next, save images. So whatever images are inserted here, so will be a high definition PNG or JPG. JPG with quality 100%. Okay, export sound when slide advances, means when slide run. Next, so who's the author? So you just write down. Okay, your home page, additional, next. Okay, so these are the select buttons. So you will be using this one, next. Apply color scheme. So you want these as a hyperlink or active link or visited link. You can select the colors also for the color scheme. The text is there, it is black color. For hyperlink it is blue, for active hyperlink it is red. Means for active link, that means the link or the word is having some link. Okay, and create. Okay, so it is saved and created. Okay, so this is the full page, right? You can see many have come, many things have come. So I'll be going to 1, 2, 3, where I have to see the name, from where I have to start it. Here, this one. So this is our practice presentation. So you can see here, click here to start. I'm pressing. So this is the online presentation. I'll press next. So next slide, press next, next slide, like a slide share. Have you seen some, you know, slides on a slide share? So I'll show you one which is very much similar to this. So if I'll be pressing any of the points, so you can see this, I'm pressing next, this is in the form of presentation. Okay, this is a bit quite, you know, this presentation is quite impressive because they have worked on it. I am just showing you how to use it. how to present it, that will take definitely much time to, you know, add some effects and all. Next is in the form of basically slide. I'm pressing next. So online presentation is going on. Click on home. Right, this is the first slide. Right, this is the second slide. This is the first page. Okay, this is the third slide. Or you want to send to email, just click on this email. So it will ask for Outlook. Outlook is a software which helps you to send the emails via the Microsoft Outlook, right? It is not configured, that's why I'm closing it, right? So these three slides have been given to us, first, second and third. We can click any of the slide, or you want to run, you click here to start. Okay, next is saving it as a PDF file, save, all, export, that's it. So this is the PDF form. So this is in the form of PDF. This is first, this is second, this is third. On third we are not having any kind of content, right? So this is in the form of PDF and all, right? Now closing the presentation, you already know, Control Q or Control W or Alt F4, right? These are the options. This next is your closing a presentation, right? Just told you, I'm telling you again, right? That is Control Q or Control W, right? Or Alt F4. Or do you want to go theoretically? Go to File, just press Exit, LibreOffice, or through this cross also, which is red cross here. You click on Save, it will be saved. Now it will be closed because I just give the command to close. So let me open it again. So it is opening in OpenOffice now, because the OpenOffice can also, you know, open these slides, right? Right click, opening in LibreOffice. And there it is, our presentation. So now moving further to our next is to open a presentation. You click on File, click on Open, right? It will ask where your file is located. Just simply click on that and the file for presentation will be opened here. Or you can go with the shortcut also, Control O, that is open, right? Next is you're using Help basically. So Help is something which will ask you to, you know, to see whatever options have been given to you, right? Help function is located by selecting the LibreOffice Help tab, LibreOffice Help. So cancel, right? This is F1. So LibreOffice built-in Help for current UI is not installed on your computer. You may either install it from our website or our systems pro repositories, or read an online version. So it's not installed, that's why it's not opening. So if I'll be going online, then also that Help, these are 3D objects, 3D inserting, generating, converting, all these things are in the Impress. You can have it by clicking a simple links, that my menu, these are the menus with the explanation, right? So this is the second page, third, fourth, fifth, for these all things, right? Everything is there. So you must see to it, right? Once it is done. And these are the contents for this presentation for Impress, right? Next is your working with slides. We have already started with the working of slides. Inserting a duplicate slide is very much easy. We know that the shortcut is Control Copy and Control Paste, right? That is Control C and Control V. If I want to copy this, so I'll simply right click, copy, or I'll press Control C, and wherever I want this slide to be copied, if I want in between two and three slides, so I'll click here and press. Okay, so after that, if it is not inserted, so you can drag it. If this second you want after fourth, you can drag it here easily. While dragging, you will came to know this icon. When this icon comes, you just place the slide here. Next is inserting new slides. So very much simple. I want to insert slide after 3. Go to slide, new slide. It will be inserted. Or you just double click at the blank area, double click, the slide will be inserted. Or you press Ctrl M, the another slide will be inserted. Or you do one thing, right click on the blank area, press Ctrl F, slide, right click. Right? You can have many, ways to insert the slides and all. Next is slide layout. Just told you, slide layout. This is for table, chart, image or video. I'll be inserting. I'll be telling you of via some sort of insertion. Insertion practice. Okay. So we'll do one thing. We'll click. We have already inserted the table. Now is for image. I'll click on the image. It will ask to, insert any of the image. I'll go to documents, pictures. These are the sample pictures. So I'll insert this. So it is inserted. So now, suppose you want the picture to be, enlarged. You just click here. You can make the picture bigger, right? More bigger you want. You can insert it, you can drag it, or you want to rotate it. See, single click will help you setting the border to enlarge, and again if you click on the same, it will help you to rotate. Clear? From any given point. This is basically to make it in a 3D form, right? These are the two slides now. So we work like this. Okay. Okay. So this is like this. So you can rotate if you are double clicking on it, and for single click that means you can resize the image. Next is copying and moving slides. Copy, we know that if I want to move this, copy this slide here and Control V, so it will be pasted here. Or if I want to move this 6th slide to the 9th slide, right click, cut, it will be cutted. After that I will click 8th, so after 8th 9 will automatically get pasted. Okay. Next is using shortcut. You already know that how to use the shortcuts. Control X for cut, copy, Control C, paste, Control V. Dragging and copying, just show you the method. You can drag it, right? You can delete the slide also by just clicking right click and delete slide, or click and you have a delete button. Click on delete button. Now you have a total of 7 slides. I'll be pressing here and click on delete button. Now total of 6 slides are there. Earlier it was 7. I just deleted the 6th one. So the 7th slide will become the 6th slide because that is the ending slide. So now moving on to the renaming. I think renaming a slide, you can give the name also. Right click, rename slide. You can get, this is the title slide. Okay, you must know that the first ever slide is basically the title slide, where you are giving the topic, that like this presentation is related to this topic and we are giving the topic as a title. Okay, that is why we are having in the layout title only, blank slide, the title only. Okay, so this is the basically title and content slide. Okay, next is copying, moving and deleting the content. Very simple. You want to copy this LibreOffice Impress data here. So what do? You click here, you select, either you right click and either you right click and copy, or just click and right click or paste, or simply with the help of shortcut keys right click, select the text, copy and click wherever you want to paste, control V, that is paste. Okay, simple. Deleting the text is very much simple. You select this, either you press the backspace button or you press the delete button. Okay, then also it will be backspace and delete. These two are given to us. Undoing and returning, that means control Z and control Y. Okay, if I want to undo that changes, control Z will help me in, you know, placing my deleted text again on the same place from where it is deleted. Now I want to redo it, that means I want to delete it. So I won't select it, I just press control Y because it is already deleted. So I press the control Z, that's why. Right? Control Z is for undo, control Y is for redo. Okay. These are the options which are given here. So let me, you know, go to edit. This is undo and this is redo. You can see the signs also. Sign must be familiar to you because can come in the paper also, that what this symbol belongs to, right? What is this icon belongs to? Next is viewing a presentation. Zoom and view dialog box is there, right? So that is basically in the view tab, and here you go with the zoom. That is zoom. So either you want this to be at 100%, okay, so 100% will be there because we don't want this as at 100% because 75 is the optimal or optimal. Click here, so it will auto fit it in the given area. Okay, so you can select whatever is deemed fit according to your screen. Some of you are having bigger screen, some of you are smaller screen, according to that you can select. Okay, next is some views are there which I already told you at the starting of this lecture. Right, so outline view, notes view, handouts, slide sorter view. Let me open it again. View, this is outline view, this is first slide, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Next is notes, so in the form of notes it will come, right? Next is your slide sorter view will be coming in the form of these like images in the drives which is placed. Next is master slide, right? Next is master notes. Next is master handouts. Okay, so this header is basically header and footer. If you want to give anything, you can give, right? You can type here also whatever you want to write, that's that. And these are basically the six slides which can be you know, displayed here, which you can take as a printout. Means select six slides per page can be taken as a hard copy, as a printout. Okay, that is why it is known as handouts. Handouts basically the small things, just to give you an idea. Now coming to the normal view. Okay, so next is formatting text, very much important. So now as we are moving to our setting of our text, so you select the text first, that is your first step to apply any of the formatting techniques, formattings to the text. Formatting is basically you want to make it impressive in color schemes, font style. You first select this, you can select the font also, make it bigger, bold, italic, underline or some strike through we won't want. That is toggle shadow, some small shadow has come, you can see the difference. Okay, and next is your font. Okay, so what font you want, right? Like this, you can make according to your requirement. And don't want underline, or underline you want, you can make different underlines. Here are some options. I hope you have never seen this in Microsoft Office, because underline means a single underline, you know that, right? So select it. More options, more underlines are there, right? You can wave or double wave, you can have it in a double wave form, right? So you want to change the color of these. Control A I have pressed to select all the content. So make it bold in the center line, right? Come in the points at the up alignment, right? Or center. These are the vertical alignment, these are the horizontal alignments, okay? And now it's you know, very much simple. And this option is given in LibreOffice. You want the letters to be very tight or normal or loose or very loose or custom value, okay? So last custom value, this is the custom value. This will help you, you know, setting your custom value, spacing and all, okay? So it will look like. Next is your font and all. I have just shown you, right? Some shortcuts have been given to us. If I want to, you know, increase the size, so I'll press the control and square right bracket. I am pressing continuously. I have pressed the control key. Now I am pressing the left square bracket. It will decrease the size. Two times I have pressed. Now is the third time. This one. Now I am increasing. I'll be pressed once that right square. I'll show you what is the right square. Square bracket. Once I have clicked second, thrice, quadruple. Okay. So I am showing you this is the left square. This is the right square. This is the left square bracket. So for bold, control B, control I, control U for italics and underline, right? So now is H2O. So 2 I want. Sorry, this is not O, this is O. 2 I want in, you know, the lower case, right? At the baseline. So this is shift control B. Shift control B. Okay. If I'll press shift control P, it will goes in a raise to power form, in an exponential form. Okay. So B is H2O like this. You can do like this also from the properties. Okay. So you can easily do it. It's up to you. Next is your bullets and numbering. I just told you how to set your bullets and numbering, right? From the day one, from the starting of this session, first chapter I am telling you, and from chapter third also, unit third also, I told you how to, you know, set your numbering, spacing and all. So this is working with tables. I just shown you at the starting of this lecture how to insert a table, what you can do in the table and all. Just press the tab to switch to from next box to from one box to another box. You can insert columns also. I have just shown you. If you want to insert column here, you go to insert, right? This is the table, right? And you can simply insert any of the table. And this has been given to you, okay? You just right click here, insert column before it will come, before date, okay? So can you see that before date, I'm pressing control Z, it will come to the last position. So like this you can do, select a table, control, you will select from here, or either you click, you select it from the very much starting of the cell, okay? Adjusting column width and row height using the mouse. So using the mouse is very much, mouse is very much simple, right? You will select it, okay? So you can adjust the rows and columns. You must see that a ruler is placed here, because the ruler is not here, because in the PowerPoint presentation also, ruler used to be there at the top, so that we could adjust the, you know, line spacing and all, or the width or height, okay? So select, you can do size, okay, optimal row height, distribute rows equally, minimum column, minimal row, optimal row, Okay, so if I'll be selecting all, I'll just right click, size, optimal row height, optimal column width. So according to the, you know, the content, it will automatically fit it according to the width. Okay, table borders and background. So if you want to give any border color, these things, you can select from here. After selecting, you can see this, that the color is getting changed. Okay, total row and first column, you want, you will select it. Okay, so this is the kind of thing. Total row will not be there. These are the serial number, this is the header. So like this, you can give the color. Okay, banded column, last column, whatever design you want, you can select it. It's very simple and is up to you. Okay, you can change the color also, right? You can change the color from here. Okay, so yellow, this is very light yellow color. So this is a bit simple. You can change, or you want to delete this, you will just see delete, and you press this. When the four arrow directions will come, you click and press the right click, and you want to delete, delete row, delete column. Okay, so you selected all the rows and you clicked on the delete column, every column will be deleted. So that means the whole table will be deleted, right? Adding images, images just shown you how to, you know, add it or how to resize it, how to move it. This is copy. I am selecting this, right click, copy, I'll paste it here, it get pasted. Okay, so let me make it to the previous position. Let me, you know, adjust the image for you so that you could familiarize with how to resize it, how to, you know, rotate it according to your desire and all. You can see this, and after that is the rotating thing. Once you click on the image, it will give you the access to resize, and if you click again on the same image, then it will help you to rotate that. Okay, so the next one is managing graphic objects. Basically, you will draw some objects or things. So let me insert a new slide for you so that I could show you the drawing shapes. Okay, and delete this because I'll be drawing different shapes here. Okay, so what I do, I'll go to, you know, the view, right? Then I will go to toolbar, then drawings. These are the drawings basically, just to enable this toolbar. This I want to draw different shapes. I can draw, these are some mathematical shapes and all. Okay, color, because I, so this is basically changing the color, right? Color here, I have selected four different colors here, and next is drawing lines. Let me insert new again. These are the lines which have been, right? So it is very much, you know, sometimes it's get difficult to, you know, insert a straight line. So if you press shift, right, it will give you the straight line. Okay, so these are the different lines which will help you to, you know, measure it with some centimeters and all, right? And if you want to make it 12, okay, not 12 basically, this is basically value increase, it will give you the line segment, right, with the caption that is, and this is basically the angle, right? You can draw easily. And next is some different kind of shapes which helps you to make it a curved one or designer one, right? Like in Photoshop we used to have, okay? So you have to just simply click, and once you press the escape button, it will vanish away, okay? So you can drag it. Next is your different shapes, right? Like a curve or arc. These are more shapes which help you insert, right? Cylindrical shape or callouts. Callouts are basically your, they are telling that what is the meaning of this or that, like the comments and all, like what is in this box. So you will write it here, right? You can write the caption, sorry. Write the caption easily. So if it is going out, you can press the enter button. Okay. So it is like this. Different shapes and all. Now grouping the shapes very much easier. Suppose you have these two shapes, so you want to, just make these two shapes a one shape. That means if you rotate this circle, the sun will definitely goes with it, like this. So how to group themselves basically with each other? What you have to do is you will click this and you press shift button here, and while pressing the shift button, you will be, having an access or facility to select whatever, wherever you will be clicking on any of the shape. Then press Control Shift G. Okay, so now these four are grouped together, and wherever you click on any of the shape, all four will move simultaneously. Okay, and this is with the help of Control Shift G, that means group. Okay, so next is your ungrouping. Very simple, Control Alt Shift G. Okay, so now you can select any of the, the shape and all according to your desire. Now you can, edit these shapes also with this one single point, right? You can change it. This is the point which helps you to edit the points here. Circle we don't have basically. This is some kind of shape, right? Next is working with slides. We are working with slide basically, how to add transition. I just showed you, right? But how to, this was the last topic, how to apply animation. This is not enlisted in your chapter, so let me explain that also for you, so that it will be easier for you to understand how you can put the effects and all, how you can apply the animations to the text. So you just select these, you click here on the animation tab, then press the plus button. So if while you press the plus button, right, at for hello, what you want, you just click on any of the animation, right, for appear. Next is this, how to select. sorry, how to apply to hello or how are you. You click on add, right? This is the add effect. So this is the first one. Double click for the timings and all. You can press on click whenever the presentation is there. So one person used to be there to operate that presentation, right? Either you want your presentation to be clicked by any of the person, that now is the first slide, now is the second slide, just move my slide to the third one. So, or you will be fluently speaking and automatically after previous slide, each and every slide will be coming with a delay of 3 or 4 seconds, or for 5 seconds. After 5 seconds, every slide will be changing itself. No need to click it again and again. Okay, so this is what the slideshow means, that when the presenter is there, there is a synchronization between the presentation and the, you know, presentation and the presenter or the speaker. After 5 seconds means in 5 seconds you have to, you know, explain that whatever topic you have started. Okay, so this is what presentation is. So that's it from our side for this unit. It is already over now. So if you have any kind of query, you can ask, you can, you know, send a query message, you can send via ERP, you can comment on the video also. So this will be uploaded soon on your ERP, that on your YouTube, right? So hope you understood it. So thank you and have a nice day. Bye bye.